Hello everyone, I am Meenu Agarwal and today I will be discussing the topic Extraction of Crude Enzymes. In this topic, I will be discussing about microbial fermentation and its types, intracellular and extracellular enzymes, enzyme preparation approaches and steps. Now talking about enzymes production. Industrial enzyme production has expanded rapidly in terms of both volume and quantity. Due to the expanding market and increasing demand for novel and stable biocatalysts, which are having potential applications in various industrial sectors. Although microorganisms constitute the largest and most dominating source of enzymes, several enzymes have also been obtained from plant and animal sources. Production of a microbial enzyme initially involves screening of microorganisms with desirable and useful property. The level of natural enzyme production from an organism is often very low, and therefore it is essential that the production levels are to be increased so to meet the industrial demand. This is achieved by optimization of medium and culture conditions or by causing mutation in the organism. The microorganisms that are used for enzyme production are grown in bioreactors or fermenters under optimized medium and culture conditions. Both solid state and submerged fermentation method are used industrially. The enzymes are separated from the microbial culture using centrifugation or filtration, and then they are stabilized to maintain suitable shelf life. In this lecture, I will be talking about enzyme production process starting from the raw material to the finished product. Fermentation technology. It involves the growth of microorganisms like fungi, yeast, bacteria under well-defined conditions for the production of enzymes which have industrial applications. Fermentation can be of two types. It can be submerged fermentation or solid state fermentation. Now, what is submerged fermentation? It is a process involving the development of microorganisms in a liquid broth. This liquid broth, it contains nutrients and it results in the production of industrial enzymes, antibiotics or any other products. The process involves taking a specific microorganism such as fungi and placing it in a very small closed flask containing the rich nutrient broth. A high volume of oxygen is also required for the process. The production of enzyme then occurs when the fungi interact with the nutrients on the broth, resulting in them being broken down. At industrial level, this production of yeast has become a major output of microbiological industries as a result of improved fermentation technology. And when we talk about solid state fermentation, it is a process that is used in the production of fuel, food, pharmaceutical and industrial products. It is basically used as an alternative to submerged fermentation. It is the use of microorganisms in a controlled environment to produce enzymes, fuel and nutrients. Solid state fermentation, it occurs in the absence of free water. It is much more simple process which requires a lot less energy. It produces a much higher volumetric productivity and it is similar to the natural environment of certain fungi. Now, the enzymes that are produced by solid state or submerged fermentation are to be further extracted by various methods. One such method is centrifugation. This is used for the enzymes that are produced extracellularly, and cell lysis And the second method is cell lysis, that is disruption, for enzymes that are produced intracellularly. Enzymes that are produced by fermentation can be intracellular or extracellular. Now, talking about intracellular enzymes, these are the enzymes which are produced internally within the cell for use inside the cell itself. For example, respiratory enzymes that are involved in the mitochondria of a cell are produced intracellularly. What are extracellular enzymes? These are the enzymes which are produced inside the cell but released externally for biocatalysts outside the cell. For example, digestive hydrolytic enzymes like protease, amylase, lipase, they are released by microbes into fermentation medium for hydrolyzing large proteins, carbohydrate, or fat molecules into smaller fragments for the easy absorption into the cell. Now, talking about preparation of enzymes. Enzymes can be produced extracellularly or intracellularly by the microbe or are released from the cell's tissues into solution. The figure that is being shown here, it outlines a view of the various stages for obtaining an enzyme preparation after being produced. Post the microbial fermentation as well as the plant animal tissue disintegration, the next and the most important step is the solid-liquid separation, which separates the cell mass from the broth or removes the cell debris that are produced after cell lysis. The filtrate, which contains soluble enzyme, is collected either by filtration or centrifugation. The filtrate is further processed or purified to obtain the desired enzyme product. Now, talking about the steps in enzyme production. Production of extracellular enzymes by centrifugation. Centrifugation, it separates the liquid and solid phases on the basis of their particle size and density. For enzymes that are produced extracellularly, the culture broth is centrifuged at a very high speed so as to obtain the filtrate which contains the enzyme of interest. The temperature is kept low during centrifugation to prevent the enzymes from getting denatured. The microbial pellet that is obtained after centrifugation, it can be further disintegrated to obtain any intracellular enzyme of interest. Generally, centrifugation is the most preferred method for recovering extracellular enzymes. Now, production of intracellular enzymes. The release of intracellular enzyme from cells require lysis of cell and then the further processing is being done. Some types of the cell, for example, gram-negative bacteria or animal cells, they are easily lysed by gentle treatment such as osmotic shock, while some others, for example yeast or some gram-positive bacteria, they are able to resist cell breakage. And thus, a variety of cell disruption techniques has been developed. In the next lecture, we will be discussing about the various techniques that are used for cell disruption. That's all for today. Thank you.